Hey, so in this video, I'm gonna show you a memory hack that will help you memorize any short speech in a very short period of time. Hey, this is Doug Standard with Fearless Presentations, the fastest, easiest way to eliminate public speaking fear. And on this video, I'm gonna share with you a very simple memory technique or memory hack that you can use to memorize your presentation. Now, this works really, really well for just about any type of presentation, but I find that I use this most often on a presentation that's gonna last me, maybe 10 minutes or less. So the shorter the presentation, the easier this technique is to use. It's a technique that's called the stacking technique. And just so you know, the way that the human brain works is that our minds think in pictures, not words or concepts. From the time that we're 5, 6, 7 years old, we're taught that the best way to memorize something is to kind of write it down in longhand and then repeat it over and over again. The problem with that concept, though, is that when we write down the letters of the words, we're now creating a code for the concepts. Our minds think in images or pictures, and we're trying to change those pictures or images into a code like the letters and words. So a lot of times when people are designing their presentations, they're doing what we call data dumping or giving too many bullet points. Then when we look at a slide that has, 15 different bullet points or even 10, and we try to memorize that entire slide, we're basically just looking at a bunch of words that makes it very, very difficult for the brain to comprehend. That's why most people, when they try to memorize a presentation, they'll really have a challenge doing it. So basically, all you really need to do is take just a few concepts. Let's say you're gonna be speaking for 10 minutes or so, and you've got 3, maybe 4 bullet points, 5 max, that you're gonna be covering in your presentation. Just create an outline of those 3, 4, 5 things that you're gonna be covering, and then create a mental image for each one of your bullet points. Really, really simple. So I'll give you an example. Let's say, for instance, that I've got a presentation, and the presentation title is How We're Going to Increase Profit Next Quarter. Pretty simple. And there's 3 concepts I'm gonna cover. Let's say the first concept is that in order to increase profit, we're gonna cut costs. We're gonna cut costs by, say, buying in bulk. The second thing that we're gonna do this quarter is we're going to try to reduce rework that we've done in the past by communicating more effectively with our current customers. And then the third thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna reach out to past customers and see if we can resell them, see if we can sell them something else. So let's say that's the concepts that I'm gonna be covering in the presentation. All I've really gotta do is go back to each one of those items or each one of those bullets and come up with a specific picture that helps me memorize that thing. So that very first bullet point was about cutting costs by buying in bulk. Well, if I wanted to create an image that helps me remember to cut cost, basically, I can picture in my head a pair of scissors cutting a price tag. The second picture was about how we're gonna try to reduce rework. Now, that's a little bit tougher to make a picture out of, but the thing that I think of when I think of rework or redoing something is I kind of remember back when I was learning to play golf and played in my first golf tournament, and you could actually buy mulligans, which was a great concept. You could actually buy redos. So when I think of a mulligan, I think of a redo. The third concept was that we need to reach out to past customers, and try to resell them. So if I wanted to come up with a picture for this concept, I might picture one of my salespeople or somebody on my sales team with long, long, long stretchy arms. You know, back when I was a kid, they had these things called Stretch Armstrongs. That's how old I am, right? And it's a doll that you could stretch his arms out. So if I kind of picture one of my sales reps with Stretch Armstrong kind of arms, it means that they're reaching out, and maybe those arms are reaching out to a satisfied customer. It makes it easy for me to remember that concept as well. So it takes a little bit longer to come up with the images, but once you have the images, you'll be shocked at how easy it is now to remember the concepts. The last step in this stacking technique process is you just have to go from one picture to the next with some type of action, with some type of imagery, with some type of, if you can add danger in there, it makes it a little bit easier. So the first concept was the scissors cutting the price tag, and I have to find some way to connect that to the golfer who's calling a mulligan. So how do I connect those things together? Well, it's real easy. All I have to do is when the scissors cut that price tag, each one of the price tag pieces or halves kind of fall on either side of the golfer. And that might be what causes the golfer to do that bad swing. which is why now he pulls out his mulligan, right? So basically it's creating kind of a story almost. We're actually going from one image to the next and making it really natural. So the third image is the sales rep that has the long stretchy arms. So I have to find some way to connect the golfer with the sales rep with the long arms. Real easy, when he pulls out that golf ball and he takes the next swing, this one slices the opposite direction and it goes right around the head of the sales rep who's got the stretchy arms stretching out to the customer. By taking each one of those individual pictures and adding some type of action that gets me from one to the next, it makes it much easier when I'm under pressure to remember what the concepts are. So just for practice in your next presentation, try to organize all of the content in that speech into maybe 3 bullet points or 4 bullet points or 5 bullet points. Come up with an image for each one of those bullets and find some type of action to connect them. You'll be shocked at how easy it is now to remember all of the content for that speech. By the way, stay tuned for the next video in this series. I'm going to show you a really cool way to memorize an entire keynote speech in just a few minutes. It's what most professional speakers use, where they can just come up on stage with a microphone and remember 60 minutes of content. I'll show you how they do it. It's a real secret that some of the absolute best presenters in the world use, and you can use it in your presentations as well. Hey, make sure and subscribe to the channel and leave a comment below. Let me know what you think of the stacking technique and how you've been able to use this in your own presentations. We'll see you on the next video.